Excuses home workout video. We're going to show you how to get a great workout in at your house using only a few items that you'll have lying around. First, a 1 gallon water jug, roll of masking tape, broomstick, plastic bag, and finally a towel. With these 5 items and a little bit of hard work, we're going to show you how you can get in great shape with an easy workout program. Our program is divided up into 3 one-day workouts. Our first day is going to be legs, then you'll have 1 day rest. We'll then move to upper body, 1 day rest. Then you'll have a full body core workout to finish off the week with the entire weekend to recover and get ready for the following Monday. So let's get started with day 1, which will be legs. This is our legs and cardio. Our first exercise is going to be a complex lunge. Awesome, we'll be demonstrating. You're gonna lunge forward. You can have your hands wherever's comfortable. You're then going to lunge back using the same leg and then step to the side. You're gonna go ahead and do 5 reps with 1 leg. Forward, backwards, to the side. As he moves forward, he's gonna work the hamstrings and the glutes to the back, focusing on the quad, and then the lunges to his right, he's working the inner part of his leg and the muscles in the groin area. Once he has 5 to the right side, he's then going to switch it over and go 5 to the left side. Make sure that when you're lunging, you're keeping your back foot stationary. Don't pick that foot up. The natural tendency when you first begin would be to try to cheat and move that back leg. If you need to shorten down your lunge, the distance that you're stepping, go ahead and do that. It's more important to shorten down that distance and keep that back foot stationary. Once he's finished his 5 reps to the left side, we'll then move on to the next exercise. Now we have bridges. You're going to leave 1 foot planted on the floor. He's going to begin with his left leg on the ground. Put your opposite leg extended straight. You're going to push off the foot that's planted on the floor and just bridge your back. You're not trying to take it into an arch position. You're just bringing it so your entire body is in a straight line. If you notice here from the knee all the way coming down to the hip up to the armpit, his goal is to have that be in a straight line. Hold it for a count of 1,000 as you reach the top of the bridge. He's going to finish up 10 reps on his left leg and then move on to the right leg. Keep your elbows and your arms just in a relaxed position on the ground. If you need to put them on the floor, that's fine. Just make sure that you're using your leg and your core as the part of your body that's going to help raise you up. Don't push off of your elbows or shoulders. He'll complete his 10 reps on the right leg, and then we'll move on to our 30-second sprints. You put them just below the kneecaps. You may need to fold one or both of them over to create the correct width. You're going to put your hands on the ground to stabilize, legs in the air. You're gonna squeeze, working the muscles surrounding the groin area. You're gonna hold for a count of 1,000 for each rep, and you're gonna do 10 repetitions, the same as you did for all the previous exercises. Now we'll move on to squat jumps. Here you're gonna get your feet shoulder width apart. Get into a squat position. Make sure you at least get your legs to a 90 degree angle. You can use your arms to help you gain momentum, and then you're going to explode and jump as high as you can. Make sure that on the jump, you're trying to fully extend your ankles, knees, and also your hips. When you jump, you want to try to drive those hips forward, throw your chest and arms into the air. When you land, try to land softly on your toes. Once you have your balance, You'll squat and jump again. You're going to do 10 jumps. Each jump is maximum capacity. You're trying to jump as high as you can on each one of the repetitions. This exercise is called squat hop. You're going to get down into a squat position, but instead of being on your heels, your weight is going to be more onto your toes, and then you're going to perform 30 small hops. Keep your hands about eye level. Be soft on your feet. You'll feel it in your calves and your quads primarily. Also, make sure you keep your core tight. Don't allow your back to slump. As you've seen in the picture, we've laid down 5 pieces of masking tape, a little bit over a foot apart. You can do the same thing at your house, and we'll show you the 5 footwork exercises you're going to do for 2.5 minutes. The first exercise is 1 foot in each box. You're going to go down and back 2 times. Then you're going to rest for 10 seconds. Make sure you're going full intensity during the footwork, and then resting for 10 before you go on to the next one. All right, our second footwork exercise is both feet in each box. His left foot is touching the floor first on the way down and back. Then he's gonna alternate and have the right foot touching in, down and back. The third one is he's gonna face towards the camera. Left foot will be leading. Both feet touch in each box. On the way back, the right foot is leading. Left foot, right foot. Rest for 10 seconds. Again, the arms are involved in each one of the drills. The fourth exercise is a lateral in and out. They'll face towards the tape. It's gonna be shuffling through. Trying to stay low, keeping the arms involved. Down and back twice, the same as the previous 3 drills. Last one coming back. The 5th and final footwork drill. He's going to be moving laterally, in and out, using tight footwork, keeping the arms involved, keeping a low base, trying to maintain your balance. Make sure you're not taking large steps. Keep the feet tight and approximately shoulder width apart. To finish off the workout, you're going to do 2.5 minutes of cardio exercises, beginning with high knees, running place. Make sure you keep your arms involved with the high knees. Be soft on your feet. Try to maintain good posture. Head and eyes looking straight ahead. 15 seconds left. Three steps and a high knee. 15 seconds left. Make sure you're focusing on your breathing, maintaining a consistent pattern the entire way through. 5 seconds left. And final exercise is frog jumps. You're gonna bring your knees up. Try to have your hands parallel to the floor. As you explode up into your jump, you'll raise your knees up to your hands. Try your best not to bring your hands down to meet the knees. Focus on your lower abdominals when you're trying to raise those legs up. 10 seconds left. 5. And stop.